Hey guys, Nick here from the Xtreme Training Academy. Been a while since I've made a video for YouTube and Facebook, so I wanted to make a quick video for you guys. In this video, I'm going to show you guys a drill that I do here with my Jeet Kune Do students called changing of the guard. I do this with my beginner guys, I do this with my intermediate guys, I do this with the advanced guys. It's a very progressive drill, a lot of fun, and hopefully you guys will like this too. Changing of the guard is about honing in on a particular moment. The moment is going from defense to offense. Now I know in a lot of JKD mentality, we don't have defense in Jeet Kune Do, a lot of people say, which is fine and dandy, but when you get blitzed from the side or blindsided from behind you or clubbed upside the head and your arms go to protect your head, then I'm going to turn around and tell you that there's no defense in JKD and you should be intercepting. So in my mindset, there is a lot of defense, and defense is paramount to everything because things like consciousness, vision, breathing, these things are very imperative in self-defense and anything combative. Okay, so we have this drill called changing of the guard. Changing of the guard is a drill that you do after your students get acclimated to good defense. They know how to catch, they know how to parry, they know how to cover, they know how to slip the head around. They know how to have good footwork. They have a good base, good structure. All these things are gonna be tested in a drill like this. Now, what I'm gonna show you guys is a day one version of this drill. It's a format, it's a framework. We can add stuff to it. We can increase the intensity. We can add different techniques to it. For the purpose of the video, I'm gonna keep this very simple for you guys. I'm gonna have a partner who's gonna be giving me jabs, crosses, hooks, uppercuts. My job is to play defense until I find a moment to go from defense to offense, okay? Quickly and abruptly and with authority. And so therein lies the name, changing of the guard. So going from defense to offense. Let me bring up Brian. Guys, this is Brian. Brian's a student of mine, has been for a while, comes out of a boxing background originally. Brian's just a great brawler, great intensity, okay? So. You know, you have to have people like that too, who aren't just technicians, people who just have an instinct to hit. And Brian's definitely been one of those guys for me in the years that he's been training with me. So Brian's gonna end up feeding me some jabs, some crosses, some hooks, some uppercuts. My job is to play defense, catch, pat, parry, cover, destroy, whatever I know, and then return. Now for the purpose of the drill, I'm going to return with my eye jab, okay, or the BUG. Because Brian and I are not wearing helmets and mouthpieces and that kind of thing, I'm going to turn around and touch him in the shoulder or on this shoulder, depends on where we're at, okay? If I can touch the shoulder, I can touch the head. It's the same, distance-wise, pretty much the same thing. I don't want to hurt him, but if you guys have safety gear on, by all means, go for it, okay? Let him have after it. So here we go. Brian's gonna start off, I always start off. Can't be so far away that there's no exchange. You have to force yourself to be in a place where my defense is still effective, but I'm not so close that he can just throw barrages at me and get me all caught up, even though there's defenses to that as well. So I always say one step and touch the shoulder, okay? I don't want to be able to touch him or have him be able to touch me just by putting his arm out. You put your arm out, okay, you see how he's a few inches short? For him to make contact, he would have to take one step. Okay, so that's a good range to start a drill like this and try to maintain that range, okay? So this is kind of what it looks like. Here we go. See what we're doing there. We just have one side feeding consistently, not too hard, not this, I'll have Brian or whoever my partner is punch a little bit more deeply. Right now he's holding his punches. So right about here, and I can defend right in front of him. But as we pick up the pace, he might be in this deep, which means my structure has to change, my footwork has to come in, I have to move. All that is progressive. In the beginning stages, start off nice and slow, and just get used to the hands. View of changing of the guard. One more time. Okay. Have some fun with it. Go try. We'll see you guys in the next one.